As an engineer, it struck me that the population is growing. By 2050, worldwide we'll have like 9 billion people on this planet, and our consumption is increasing. Our consumption is troubling because we don't have enough resources to supply basically our appetite for better and better product, new product all the time. The rate of material consumption that we have is not sustainable, given that half of what we use is non-renewable resources. Since the beginning of the Industrial Revolution, we have done things in a certain way where we had abundance of materials and the pollution was not an issue. Things have changed, our approaches have not. So what we're doing is that we're trying to really re-examine all of our approaches to making product and actually going all the way to how we consume product and how we use product as well. It became apparent that we gotta really do something about the educational side, how we train people in this area. We have to be system thinkers, and not only one single discipline can actually make a change. So if we don't approach the problem from all of its angles, we're not gonna be able to meet our goals. So from an educational perspective, we start to think about, we should really create an educational program focused on the science of sustainability. When people think of sustainability, immediately they start thinking of environmental related issues. We start that way as well, but we start looking into what really can help us achieve that goal. So in many, many cases, it's through innovation in technology, through innovation in process, through changes in the way we design system. One of the things that we have worked on here at RIT is that we created several generations of a product that had embedded sensors that can be used in transportation applications. So we partner with the government in this area. We got support and funding to develop this technology. Then we spun off a company that actually is doing this in trucking application. Without making any changes in the hardware itself, we're able to lower our fuel consumption by 10 to 15%. We made the truck smarter. We're able to monitor the mechanical system well. We're able to monitor fuel consumption. We're able to make corrections that allowed us to achieve this goal. We have 2 patents on the system, and we have 4 more on the software side as well. It seems like there are no limitation of what we can do, from lithium-ion battery work to energy storage to nanomaterial that can have a significant impact on new product in terms of life and durability, to a lot of work that we're doing in the green chemistry side, in the pollution prevention side. So it seems like we uncovered many, many opportunities where change can happen, where innovation can make a difference. The pioneering work I think that we're doing in education, the exciting research, when you get students working on e-waste and taking computers apart and saying, gee, I never knew that there's so much material go to waste after a very short period of time. What can we do about this? And just see that transformation in their thinking and the impact that some of this work have on the students. It is fantastic to see the innovation they have and the excitement they have. But what really excites me about this is that we saved hundreds of millions of tons of material from going to landfill. It's a win-win for everyone. It's just an example where our innovative thinking can come to play in solving a major challenge, and we can see some truly tangible benefits of doing that. Our work started in the remanufacturing and recycling area. We're very fortunate that we were able to create that program, and we were able to bring industry and government support for the new building for the Galisano Institute for Sustainability. RIT has a culture of doing applied research. We're valuing the partnership with industry. We have co-op programs that are phenomenal, and we have terrific students and faculty. It's a great place to start innovative activities here, and we actually paid our dues. We worked very hard for years. We have over 20 years worth of work in this area, and I believe that what we were able to do here at RIT would have been very difficult to do anyplace else. As an engineer that has been trained in a certain way of action from design to manufacturing, when you actually see that there is a much better way to do it, that there is a phenomenal ways that we can achieve our goal with a lot less emission pollution. And this is what drives me, is the fact that I know that we can make a difference. I know we can achieve these goals. We started well, and I think there's a lot more to be done. But there's a lot more to be done. We have to work hard to make sure that we achieve our objectives. We just have to explain that to people. We have to be part of that transition that have to take place in our industrial system. And that's very satisfying to be part of that change. I feel our generation have this opportunity now because we have to re-examine many of those methods and see if we can find better material we can recycle. We need to design product that can last longer and provide better function. So all of that is very exciting for an engineer to wake up in the morning and say, I want to continue to do all I can to help make a difference in this area.